Hello Cloud Gurus, I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of the Kubernetes book and Quick Start Kubernetes, a hands-on guide, and this is Kubernetes This Month, the show that keeps you right up to date with all the good stuff happening in the world of Kubernetes. So here's my five picks from what's been going on in the past month. First up, Sysdig continues its march towards securing DevOps with the acquisition of Apolicy. Among other things, they'll be getting policy as code and automated remediation workflows. And for me, this is yet another sign that Kubernetes and cloud-native security is a huge deal and the ecosystem is making huge strides forward. Congratulations to the team at ContainIQ on their public launch. They're all about Kubernetes native monitoring and dashboards that just work. So monitoring for mere mortals. And a bit like the Sysdig and Apolicy stuff, this is another real sign that Kubernetes is getting more and more enterprise friendly with proper security and monitoring. Platform9, who've got huge pedigree in managed containers and Kubernetes, well, they've just unveiled a managed KubeVirt solution for running containers and VMs shoulder to shoulder on Kubernetes. And we'll dig into that a bit in the deeper dive section. The Kubernetes project itself released a great blog recently outlining the APIs and features that are removed in Kubernetes 1.22. Now, this is seriously important stuff, so we'll look at that in the deep dive section as well. And then last up for this month, the Open Containers Initiative released version 1.0 of Runc. So Runc is the super low-level tool for spawning and running containers that comply with the OCI spec, which includes Docker containers and obviously therefore most containers running on Kubernetes. And that's the news roundup for this month. Okay, for the deeper dive section this month, we will look at API and feature deprecation and Platform9's KubeVirt solution. Okay, deprecation and removal of features is obviously important. I mean, none of us want to move to a new version of Kubernetes only to find a bunch of our stuff stops working. No thanks. So, knowing when stuff's being deprecated and more importantly, when it's actually being removed, it's super important. But backing up real quick, the whole process works like this. You have features and APIs that are being used, but stuff is always evolving and improving, so newer versions get released. And while multiple versions of the same APIs and features can exist side by side in the same version of Kubernetes, and that's fine, however, eventually it becomes time to remove the older versions. And the first step is to deprecate the older versions, which is just a fancy word for telling people to basically stop using them, or, you know what, at least start planning to move to the newer version. But while a feature is deprecated, it still exists and you can use it. Only when you do, you'll get warnings and log messages and the likes telling you about the deprecation and when it's planned to be removed. Anyway, a few versions after initial deprecation, the feature does eventually get removed. And this is the business end of the process because, as the name suggests, once a feature is removed, you can't use it anymore. Well, Kubernetes 1.22 removes a ton of features and some of them are big ones. So be careful when updating. For example, I got stung by ingress. I was updating a chapter of the Kubernetes book where I do everything against the latest versions and the ingress stuff stopped working. But not only did it stop working, when I updated the examples to the latest version, stuff had changed. So for me, it wasn't a super smooth transition. Well, the project's put together a nice little blog post listing all the features that are being removed, plus a bunch of helpful instructions on how to move to the newer versions. And oh, how I'd have loved that when I was updating my ingress stuff. All right then, last but not least this month, Platform9 announced their managed KubeVirt service. So KubeVirt is a nifty little project that lets you run virtual machines on a Kubernetes cluster and pretty much manage them like they're pods. And the potential is huge there, right? I mean, Kubernetes is the OS of the cloud. So that platform that we're writing and deploying our applications to, which is great, only a lot of us still have VMs that we're not going to be refactoring to containers for a long time, if ever. So KubeVirt, and especially the Platform9 managed KubeVirt service, offer the potential to run VMs and containers on Kubernetes under a unified control plane or platform. Now, the Platform9 Managed KubeVirt is a first in this space. It's a KubeVirt SaaS solution, fully managed, monitored, and fully supported by Platform9. And like I think I said before, these guys have huge pedigree in managed containers and Kubernetes. So it is full of things like managed upgrades, built-in monitoring, RBAC, quotas, and boatloads more. And you know what? It's all fronted by a console that's really easy to use. Definitely worth a look. Well, that's it for this month's Kubernetes This Month. If you like the show, be sure to give the episode a big thumbs up. Have a question? Add it into the comments. Stay safe, and I'll be here again next month, so don't forget to subscribe. Same Kube time, same Kube place.